red carpet from the stables of Royal Arts Academy. Everyone dressed to the teeth. And my song to try our movie. But we expect it's all about us. It's all about our movie industry. It's all about Nollywood. Tonight we're here again on the red carpet. And of course, I'm going to be talking with different kinds of celebrities from the continent of Africa. And of course, in Nigeria. I'm waiting to get drilled. I want to see who's trendy and who's trashy on the red carpet. Of course, definitely we're on point with what's up in Nollywood. What's going on? Who's been doing what? What's the buzz been about in the movie industry? We'll find out tonight. My name is Wafa Samuel. Let's set the ball rolling just like this. Thanks so much to my designer for putting my outfit together. That is my FOB Couture. That's what's up.
Proud, and I feel very, very glad that I'm part and parcel of this wonderful premiere tonight.
One word for the producer and director of the movie, MM Song.
MM is one of the most influential, one of the most focused, one of the gladiators in not only in Nigeria but in Africa movie cinema.
When I heard the name of the movie, Breaking the Code of Silence, I was like, oh my God, wow. How did you come about that name?
The writer, Bola Aduo, was the one that came up with the name because we feel that there's some sort of code of silence as regards rape victims because no one wants to speak out and say anything on this. And we feel that it's about time that people begin to speak out so that maybe this menace can be curbed. And if the culprits are brought to book, then perhaps it will reduce.
Two more questions. Now, for the other stories like Apaye, Darima's Lilima, and the other movies I watched like earlier this year, you're fond of making contemporary stories that touch the heart. Now, this is about rape. How do you come about the stories? You said you didn't write this one. Somebody put this together. But how do you come about the storylines of these movies?
Sometimes these stories find you. This particular story found me. So, I did not set out to do this. It was brought to me and I felt that it was a beautiful story, and then the Nollywood Workshops in conjunction with Royal Arts Academy decided to make this movie and to send a message out there.
One last question, madam. You've actually been a strong influence in Nollywood. I read an article that said top 10 most influential personalities in showbiz from Africa, and your name was on the list. Of course, we all know in Nollywood, you're like a frontier. Now, you've been going irrespective of the odds against you. You produce movies year in year to churn out different kinds of movies every year. Whether or not you make profits, what's the zeal that keeps you going?
It's passion. Sometimes the profit comes, sometimes it doesn't. But I'm very passionate about it. I was telling somebody the other day that even if Nollywood says they're not doing it again, me, I will still make it. Because I just like to tell stories. I like to see my characters come to life. I like to affect people's lives, and I love it.
What's the stress by? Very quickly.
Oh, my stylist gave me, so I don't know. Yeah.
We'll be right back.
Justin Okoye.
My name is Eyin Awigwe.
Blessing if you're Mbe.
This is Osi Okeje.
My name is Mambi.
Makeda Moka.
They call me Vijay Adams, the King of Talk.
Gabriel Alpha Lion.
The Prince is here.
Toride Bello.
You are watching.
And you're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You are watching.
You are watching.
Fab.
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 Fab love.
With the amazing.
The most gorgeous.
Wi-Fi.
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 Don't touch that down.
Don't touch it.
Don't go nowhere.
too.
If I've ever had anyone that supported me so far in this industry, it's Ememi Song. And like I said earlier, if I want to start saying how far she's come for me, how long she's come for me as well, I won't end tonight. She's like, I don't know, it's beyond coming from the same place. She's a friend, she's a sister, she's a mentor, she's a good listener, she's everything. That is why I always come out here to support her.
What's new? Are you shooting? Are you, did you just get upset?
I have about 3 jobs that are gonna come out.
Woo!
Yes. That's one is the Scorn Help. That's directed by Iken Nebua. That's Flo Smith. That's gonna come out like next week by God's grace. Then upper week we have another one coming out, still from Ememi Song, The Glass Slippers. And then the upper one we have Of Bad Faith, still by Iken Nebua. So far we are not relenting. We are working.
Beautiful, beautiful, great. Now, spell the word silence.
Silence. Yep. S-I-L-E-N-C-E.
Beautiful. So tell me, who's this dress by?
This is my friend's dress. My friend actually designed it. It's called Stitches and Styles.
Wow. I've seen you work with Ememi a few times. Fantastic. What are the comments from you about this movie producer and director, Ememi Song?
I love her. One word, love. I'm in love with her, actually.
What's been new about you in Nollywood? More movies coming out, what are we expecting to see? Do you just leave a cinema now? You just left a movie set. What have you been up to?
I've been everywhere. I mean, we're working, we keep working. Expect a lot coming out from Nino. There's a lot coming up, thank God.
Nollywood has grown in leaps and bounds. There are lots of people who are very professional. A few persons said you were also professional too. But are there persons you see as competitors and you're threatened somehow, so to speak? Is there anything like that existing in your mind?
Well, I don't acknowledge that. I'm positive. I'm a positive person. I do my work and let God do the rest.
How would you define yourself, like in one sentence, but define your kind of person? How would it be?
Kind, friendly. Sometimes I can be an ass.
Now, your outfit tonight, nothing too serious, nothing too overstated, just simple and crunk. What informed this outfit?
Well, people that know me know I like to keep it simple. I just like to keep it simple, period.
My name is Amanda
Ibe.
Chris NNG.
Memories of Anu.
Mike Bunny Bassi.
Caesar.
Ike Obona.
Pauline Stoddard. I love Fab.
I love Fab.
And you're watching
Fab. Fab.
Fab.
Fab. Fab with what fine?
What fine?
Keep watching Fab.
Don't touch that dial.
Keep it locked.
Don't go nowhere.
My name is Eyin Anwigwe.
Blessing if you're Migwe.
This is Josie UKJ.
My name is Mambi.
Makita Moka.
They call me Vijay Adams, the king of talk. Gabriel Afolayan.
The prince is here.
Tori De Bello.
You are watching and you're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You are watching.
You are watching.
Fab.
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 Fab love.
With the amazing.
The most gorgeous.
Wafi.
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 Don't touch that down.
Don't touch it.
Very nice, just me. You know, not trying to make it so big, just me.
Thank you.
Okay, you've worked with the Mami Song a few times. Now she produced and directed this movie. What are you expecting to see from Mami Song as a director?
Okay, well, that's a lot. Actually, I'm an assistant director of the movie.
Woo!
Okay. She's the director, I'm the assistant director, and I happen to be on set quite a lot of time. I am part of it, and I know exactly what people should expect. We are trying to speak about rape, and then we're trying to make people aware on processes and things to do when it has to do with rape, both medically and both, you know, going the legal way. So with a lot of actors that we have, and with everybody that put in enough energy and strength to make this a success, I can only say go and see the movie and see how beautiful it is.
Now, I've been fortunate to see a few movies from you. Your movies are very classy, choice of cast, choice of locations, and so on. How do you get this vibe? Like, was there a specific directing school you attended in the UK, in the US, or something?
I learned in the streets. But actually, I know I did a training in South Africa in 2012, and I did another training this year in California, Los Angeles. But apart from that, I will tell you that every inspiration and creativity I've got was learned in the streets of Lagos. In fact, in the streets of
Lagos. It wasn't like you spent 10 years in Hollywood trying to learn the rudiments of directing.
In fact, I didn't even go to a proper school. I went to workshops.
Wow.
Workshops and training. 2 weeks, 1 week short courses.
Okay.
So every inspiration I've got was learned looking at the streets of Nigeria and looking at the lives of the people that we live with.
You look good. I love your hair. Your makeup, what is this?
She's called Edith. She's amazing. She does all my makeup and she's on point.
Okay, you're here on the red carpet for the movie, for the premiere of the movie Breaking the Code of Silence.
Yeah.
Expectations from tonight, I'm sure it's amazing. You're
going
to see a good movie. But if you were to describe Nollywood in a sentence, what would the sentence be?
We are growing. We are growing in a higher path. We are growing in a good place. We are growing, you know, Nollywood is quite big. And then I think now people realize how big you are. So what I would describe Nollywood is we are so growing.
If there were to be a particular Nollywood movie you'd never feature in, like any particular story you'd never be caught doing, is there anything like that?
No. I think we've told all the stories.
Why would you never be caught wearing on the red carpet for a movie premiere?
I would never wear a short skirt. No.
What?
I'm so shy. I don't like showing my legs, so I would never show my legs.
Her movies make sense. The storylines are awesome. And then this Code of Silence, I'm trying to imagine what the story is all about. Code of Silence.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Now, if there was something you could change about Nollywood in 2015, what would it be?
Well, what would I want to change now? Nollywood is so vast. It has the Yoruba version, it has the Igbo version, it has the Nollywood. But you know, the only thing I would change is like for them to record their movies with good cameras, better cameras than before, and the storylines to be more realistic.
You're here for the premiere of the movie Breaking the Code of Silence. Have you ever worked with a Mami Song?
No, I haven't, but I'm working with her on the next project.
Okay.
So you see me very soon on the red carpet again.
Great. Now, you are like a frontier in Nollywood.
Yeah.
You've been in a reality show. Of course, you know the rudiments of acting. Nollywood has evolved. But for you, if there was one thing you could change about the way we make movies from this part of the world, what would it be?
I'm thinking, well...
Nothing!
I wish if I could change one thing, it would probably be... Oh, God. Low-budget movies.
Okay, if there was one thing you wanted to see in Nollywood, what do you think we should work on a lot more to make our movies more globally accepted?
I think we should work more on our creativity in terms of our stories.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Now, what have you been up to? You've been shooting more movies.
Yeah.
I mean, you're in one with a Mami Song. I expect to see that one very soon. But anything else? Anything new?
Well, no. I've been acting in a couple of movies. I've been really busy acting. I do modeling on the side. But most of the times, I'm just acting. I'm at the gym or I'm watching movies or I'm home eating.
Beautiful.
going?
Don't look for me on CDs. Go to the cinemas. Alright? Go to the cinemas, everybody. When you want to find me, go to the cinemas. It's better for you that way.
Now, the question I want to ask you is, you've been there from the inception of Nollywood. Like, you've seen Nollywood from when it started. You're like one of its frontiers. How can we possibly get our movies more recognized in the global scene? It's recognized, but how can we possibly get it more recognized?
It's getting recognized. We own Africa. We own the Caribbean.
How can we own the world?
We've conquered the world, but we haven't subdued it yet. And we'll soon do that. We have a problem with language. Sometimes when I speak, Nigerians can't hear me, I'm Nigerian. So imagine what our foreigners will, the difficulties they might have, but we're getting there.
You look nice tonight.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm great, you look good yourself.
What is about your outfit for tonight?
To tell you the truth, I was just working, I was in the studio, and I remembered I had to be here, I promised some girls supposed to come, so I just put on, you know, what I could find, I just rushed down.
Beautiful. So what have you been working on lately?
I'm working on a couple of movies. I don't want to say too much about it, but you know, a couple of movies are going to come out soon. Just, you know, look for it.
Okay, Colin Stalker, you've been working. You look nice.
Thank you so much. I must give this to one of my designers who thought I should wear this. You're looking beautiful, right? We're here to break the code of silence.
Thank you so much, Collins. What do you think about the entire ambience? Look at everywhere. What would you say?
This is lovely. This is more like it. This is the Royal Art Academy. When they invite, everybody comes because we always expect something wonderful. And then Isong and her crew are just totally awesome. Yes.
Okay, now one word for Nollywood in 2015. How would you describe Nollywood?
Nollywood has come a long way. In 2015, we're seeing something new. The new Nollywood, if I may say so, because producers and directors and filmmakers are paying attention to details, understanding and having the international film world in mind. So it's no more making film for Nigerians, it's telling our story so the whole world can be a part of it.
Okay, right about now we have Nollywood's fine boy, Ike Ogbonna, on the red carpet. Ike has been in several Nollywood films. Of course, you've worked with MMI Song a few times. That's your baby!
It's fine. It's growing into a man real fast.
Okay, now you've worked with MMI Song a few times. How would you describe this woman?
She's humble, she's good-spirited, she's very intelligent, she's very creative, and she's a hard worker.
Ike Ogbonna, now you're known to be doing classic movies in Nollywood. Is there any particular storyline you'd ever turn down?
I'm yet to the script yet.
Your outfit tonight is goes in black, classy.
Yeah.
Decked up in black, is this a statement of the mind?
No, I just felt like dressing casual, so this is casual.
You can't call this casual with your heart.
Okay, I'll take it off.
Okay, Onyeka, it's nice to have you on the red carpet. You look fierce, daring.
I am. Everything you described me is what I am.
Fierce, daring, scary, fine, scary. Handsome, cute, nice. Okay, you're here for the premiere of the movie,
yeah.
Breaking the Code of Silence. What informed your outfit for tonight? Is it your hair?
I dress every single day. Yeah, every day.
Okay, so it means you're a true African and of course you're part of African culture.
I don't know about being a true African, but I'm an African.